Hey guys, and welcome to another episode of the quest for the Lava Crystal Ice Hammer. Today I will finally be facing Kanyata for the last time on this series at least. And I'm actually at 30 cores right now. 30. So I've actually only gotten one since last time. I said I'd have like 32 or 33. But no, Game Off decided to not let me get any for the past three exhausts before yesterday. So when I finally got number 30, so that was kind of suckish. So yeah, I'm hopefully going to be able to get it by Sunday, which is when I want to do the last episode and invite you all to Sinskald Rift so we can all go there to upgrade my hammer and dance together and whatever, just have fun. So hopefully that'll be Sunday, but I'm not sure yet. One thing I wanted to say was yesterday for the arena style video. Sorry about that with my voice. Like, I was just trying to be funny because I was really tired and I didn't know what else to do. I know a lot of people like dislike that video, so sorry about that. So today I want to talk about Kanyata and the first week of GSL and how this was by far the hardest dungeon. I had said that RKO was the hardest at the time, but I did not think about GSL at all because for me, this was freaking impossible the first time it came out. And now it's actually a lot easier than it was, so I don't know how well I'd be doing right now if it was still how it originally was when GSL first came out. Kanyata had tons of health, and the vines did a ton of poison, and it was just completely impossible. Some teams were able to master it, like the best geared, and I wasn't the best geared back then. So now, like these days, I'd probably be able to do it a lot more easily than I could back then. But I remember the first week, and actually like the first few months, I could not complete it, and I just gave up, and I just farmed tight with people, just for fun. That's why I didn't play as hardcore, and that's actually when a lot of people got a bunch of souls. That's basically like the number one time that people were getting souls, so I missed out on all that because I wasn't able to farm GSL. Also, I remember it being daytime and how fun that was. I mean, that was just a blast. I don't know why Game Loft would make it not daytime. I mean, SBL would actually be a lot more fun if that it was a daytime too. Hopefully the Rift Dungeon would be daytime, but you know, the way things are going, it looks like every dungeon's gonna be nighttime. So yeah, I remember like the first week, it was impossible. I stepped in there and we killed like the vines and that was it. And like, we just completely died because you need like 6,200 HP. So definitely GSL was one of my favorite dungeons and it still is. And the secret boss was a really fun addition. I absolutely love that. So GSL is so much to explore. And there was that out of map glitch too and everything. So that was super fun. All right, moment of truth. Damn it. No core. Wow, thanks Game Loft. All right, so let's just check the chest because you guys love me to do that. So, all right. Man, that went by fast because we had like a bunch of DPS. I was going to talk about more stuff. Like, Essences of Seathian, you know, we had to get all those. We didn't know what it was for a few months. Secret Boss was so fun, trying to get the Eye Wand, which I have now. I'm not going to use it because it'll make them crash. And, yeah, the Out of Map Glitch. I made a video about that and everything. That was pretty fun. It's kind of like wall hacking, but it's not really breaking the rules. It's just, like, exploiting a glitch, I guess. Alright, so that's it for this episode. Hopefully by Saturday when I make the final Zargus, I will have more cores. I really hope so, because I want to get all my cores in by Sunday so I can make that episode. But I will keep you guys updated, so thanks for watching. I know this one was short, but I will see you guys next time for another episode of The Quest for the Lava Crystal Ice Hammer. Take care, guys.